Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, as you may have guessed from the title, this is going to be my what's on my iPhone 12 plus the iOS 14. This is highly requested video. I recently decided to upgrade my phone to iPhone 12. I used to have the iPhone SE, which gained me a lot of views, to be honest with you. I decided to make a new video about the iPhone 12 because I know a lot of you are curious to see why I decided to upgrade and what's new about the iPhone 12. So anyway, just really wanted to show you guys what's inside my iPhone 12. Honestly, I did this video like a little, probably about like 6 months ago or 4 months ago or something like that. So I thought I'd do another video featuring my new iPhone 12. Also, the video that I did before was like the previous iOS. So this time I have the iOS 14, and I know that I told you guys that I will be doing a video about the iOS 14, but I never really got the chance to do it. So I do apologize, but today is the day that I will be sharing with you guys what's inside my iPhone 12. So when you open my phone, I am one of those people, yes, put their faces as the wallpaper or the lock screen on their phone. I'm one of those. So yeah, so and as you open the phone, you see that I do have all of my apps here. I changed all of the apps using widgets, which I'm going to talk about further in this video. But as you can see, I do have a very girly home screen. This photo widget right here changes every time, so I just got the random photos of like beauty products. So that's that. And then I just change also the pictures of my different apps that I use all the time. So my notes, my camera, app store, weather, photos and whatnot. So I change all of them, and I use the app, the widget Smith, and the color widgets and the photo widgets. Those are the three apps that I used in order to maximize the iOS 14 and change like the theme of it the way I wanted it. So that's that. And then on the next page, you see that I do have my widget Smith right here, which is where I decided to do like a calendar thing, because I always want to know if I have like an event or something that I need to attend, especially like appointments. Appointments these days are like really hard to get an appointment, like for a doctor or the dentist. That's why I always have to have my calendar so that I won't miss any appointments that I may have. And then the next page, I do have my entertainment app. Obviously, I love Smule. It's so embarrassing, but I love Smule, especially when I don't really have to do anything at all. When I'm just relaxing, I just wanted to open my Smule and just sing my heart out. And then of course I do have my Prime Video and my Netflix. I also have the CBC Gym, which is actually just like really cool. You can watch, like, as you can see, like the Schitt's Creek, although I watch the Schitt's Creek on Netflix, but it's just nice that it's here. Also Family Feud. So yeah, a lot of shows are in here. I'm not sure if it's available worldwide, but yeah, I really enjoy this app. And then I also have this CoStar, which obviously I don't use at all often, but this just tells me like everything about astrology. I love astrology. I'm an Aries. This is where I would check like my Venus or my star sign and whatnot. So this is very interesting. And then next is I do have my edit apps, or this is the editing apps that I use for my photos. I use Snow for like different kinds of cute pictures and filters. So I use that. I also use Meitu, most especially for the filters, although I don't really use filters for my photos anymore. It's mostly I use this for like my stories and stuff. And then I have my beauty cam and my preview. This is where I obviously preview like the stuff that I will be posting on my Instagram. So this is very handy. That's why I have a preview. So that's that. And then the next app is of course my shopping app, which I mostly use all the time, every day. I have a problem, like what I always said, I love shopping so much. But the promise that I made for myself this 2021 is that I will try to save more money than spend money, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's my goal for 2021, is to save money, but just Just so you guys know, this is where I shop. I shop from Sephora, Amazon, AliExpress, although I don't use AliExpress, YesStyle, and DHgate, Shoppers. As you can see, some of this isn't downloaded anymore because I don't use them often. I just use my, most especially the Zara, and my Sephora and Amazon and the YesStyle. Also guys, if you guys didn't know, YesStyle, they do have an amazing sale for the new year, which I think they are having like 80% off, and you can use my code TrinaYes10 for extra 10% off all purchases. And then the next, I just wanted to share with you the cases that I received from our friends from Caseco. So thank you so much, Caseco, for sending all of these goodies. I will be definitely using all of them. So I just wanted to share with you guys what I got from Caseco. They are very, very generous and so nice, and that they sent me like cases for my iPhone 12. This is not in any way sponsored, you guys. They just sent this to me complimentary, and I just wanted to share with you guys what I got. This is, I will leave all of the details down below where you could get your cases. I really, really enjoy Caseco because they have different type of cases that are really cheap. They're way, way cheaper than getting them from the Apple store, because when I purchased my iPhone 12, they have this one case that I really, really like, but it's like so expensive. But I'm so happy because Caseco actually got me the same exact case, but like on a cheaper price. This is what the packaging looks like, and then this is the phone case. As you can see, this is just very, very straightforward. They don't really have anything at all, like they don't even have like the wipes or stuff like that. They just sent you like the really, really amazing case. And as you can see, I have this case right here, which is so nice. I really, really love this case because it has like some glitters on it, and it's very, very sturdy, you guys. So this is what I'm going to use. It's so, so cute and so stunning. I really, really like this, and it's so easy to put. And wow, this is actually soft. Like compared to the one that I'm currently using, this is legit super soft. So this is what it looks like. It has some glitters on it, which I really, really like. And as what I've said, you guys, if you purchase this one from Apple store, this would cost you so much. But I checked this on Caseco website, and this I think here is just $21. Also sent me another one, which is just like that other case, but this one is just a plain one. This doesn't have anything at all, and look how clear this is. Oof, I love clear cases for some reason. I know it's weird. I don't know, because for some reason I got white phone because I love the white phone, and it doesn't really make sense if I use like a different color of phone cases. So yeah, I just normally don't use any other color. But also they sent me this, which is a phone stand. So cute. It's like very, very easy to use if I want to watch some Netflix while I'm getting ready and stuff like that. So I really, really like this. Okay, and then last but not the least, they also sent me this one. They probably know that I don't really like cases with colors, so they just gave me this one, which I think is really, really cool and so perfect for like a guy. Or if you are a girl and you like, your aesthetic is like very, very black, I actually want to try this on. And oh, it's, and this is so easy to take off as well. If you can see, you just have to flip it right here. So this is a black case, a black lining case, and ooh, I kind of like this. I think this is like perfect if you want some edgy things. This looks like very, very edgy, and I kind of like it. And also the case is matte, so it looks very, very bougie. But this one is only for $23. Next app, or the next folder that I have here, are stories. So iMovie, this is where obviously I edit my videos, like this video that you are watching, this is where I edit my videos. Scannable, this is very, very handy, especially at work when I need to scan things and I don't have to go to like a printer or something like that. I just can do it easily on my phone. And then I have my Flow to track my cycle, obviously, but I don't use it now anymore. And then I have Canva. Vue Video is also one of the app that I use when I wanted to edit my videos. That's what I use. Template, I don't really use that. I honestly just need to go through all of the apps that I don't use and just delete all of them, because obviously I don't use a lot of them. And then okay, the next folder that I have is Spotify, SoundCloud, Camera Connect for my camera so that I can transfer all of my files on my phone. This is what I use for Canon. And I have YouTube Studio just to check my channel, of course, and then my YouTube. And then the next app is editing. So for editing, I use this mostly for my thumbnails, especially like the Fonto. This is what I use to edit my thumbnails on my YouTube. Also PixArt, that's where I use it. And the Lightroom, Adobe Clip is what I use when I wanted to do like some trailer things. So I use that. Also Photoshop Mix if I wanted to edit my wallpaper or my thumbnail. And the next one that I use, or the next folder, is social. I have my Viber, GroupMe, Facebook, Messenger, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, TikTok. I don't use TikTok anymore. I know, it's surprising. For some reason, I just find TikTok very, very distracting. That's why I tend not to watch any TikToks anymore. And then the next folder I have is lifestyle. I have my Google Home for our Google Pods here. And then I have HP Smart for a printer. And then the white disk, which I don't use anymore because I forgot where I put like my white disk. So anyway, and then I have Google Maps to check the buses, also on time to check the buses and whatnot. And then I also have another widget, Smith, right here, which changes photo every time. And then the next page is the most craziest of them all. This is where I put all of the apps that I don't normally reach out for. As you can see, I have like the Canada, which I do have my bill, my bank account, my credit cards, Starbucks and stuff like that. And then I have productivity, which I also don't use anymore, but I put like all the widgets made here. That's why it's easier for me to change like the photos and stuff like that. So this is where I put them. And next folder is the known folders. I just have PayPal, reward style, influencers, stuff like that. I really need to go through all of my apps because some of them I don't use anymore. I have stocks because I am planning to invest more in stocks, so that's why I downloaded it. And I have Fika, which I don't use anymore at all. I probably will be deleting this once I'm done with this video. It's just sad because I purchased all of this. But yeah, it's time for them to go because I don't use them anymore. And then the navigation, which I also don't use, and then extras, which I don't use at all anymore. I probably need to go through all of this just to delete them because it sucks that I don't use them. And then for my Apple Watch, I do have my folder for my Apple Watch because I have my Apple Watch right here, which I also need to do a video of. I know. Anyway, so this is where I put like my Apple apps. I have my numerics, my fitness tips, the watch where I edit all of the stuff from my Apple Watch. And then for some reason I have my OLG lottery here because I always join the lotto here in Canada just in case. But yeah, it's just some random stuff. And then all of the stuff that are in here are the stuff that I recently just downloaded and I never really had the chance to put them in their right folder. That's why they're all here. And yeah, so that's just basically it, you guys. I also have like the games, which I'm trying because of the arcade games. Because I purchased a new iPhone 12, they gave me like 3 months free of arcade games. That's why I've been trying to download some of them, but they are ridiculously heavy. Like one app of this is like 2 gig or something like that. So it just eats up all of my gigs. That's why I don't use them anymore. But I really, really enjoy this Alba app. I don't know, it's just really fun. So it's just like Dora, where she has like all this adventures and whatnot. And then I have my Coco app. This is the Milky app. So that's basically it, you guys. That's everything that I have on my iPhone 12. If you wanted to see how I use the iOS 14 or how I organize all of my apps using the iOS 14, then leave a comment down below and I'll definitely do another video or a separate video of all about the iOS 14. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoy it. And as always, if you have any questions, leave them down below and I will answer them for you. And I'll see you on my next one. Bye.